Hey, how's it going, everyone? And welcome to the final part of the speedrun tutorials for Astro's Playroom in the speedrun challenges. This is the rolling run and is probably one of the most toughest because the controls can feel a little clunky at times. So there's not really a whole lot of tips that I can give you on this one, except it's kind of like the climbing run. You really just kind of have to keep practicing until you get a good rhythm going. So one thing that I do that I found out, I seem to keep top speed a little better whenever I use my thumbs, and I can also keep the ball rolling straighter whenever I use both of my thumbs. But whenever I need to make turns or make adjustments, stuff like that, it's easier if I switch to my index finger. So that's probably something you would want to consider, maybe changing some things up like that to kind of help you to more precisely get around turns and get through this stage faster. And I am actually going to tell you a couple of things that I noticed that will help you cut down your time. Like I said, there's not really a whole lot I can help you with on this video. Maybe probably one of the biggest things I will say at this very beginning part, just kind of practice a little bit going around these two little sand areas. And maybe whenever you kind of get that, get a good pace going, you've kind of figured out at that point what you want to do to your top speed. So I'm just going to go ahead and let the video start. So like I said, it's beginning, it's pretty straightforward. We're just going to go straight out of here. You see I use my thumbs here. And then on these two little parts right here where the sand is, if you can, try to barely go around them. Like, you want to stay as straight as possible. Keep going forward in a straight line as much as possible, because that will help cut down your time as well. And it's also important to note that pretty much this entire course is going uphill. So any slight pause or adjustments that you may make where you're not going forward is going to start cutting into your... So like I said, on these two parts, just try to barely go around if you can, and that will save you some time. This part's pretty tricky. As you can see, you have like a really narrow path to take. And on this, you'll notice that I've actually switched to using both my fingers. Because like I said before, I have an easier time making turns whenever using my index fingers. And whenever I'm coming down straightaways, I usually switch to thumbs because I can get back to top speed. I do lose some speed throughout here. Not much, but it is a bit of a time. Because this part's really critical that you don't touch the sand. So with this, it's kind of better if you can kind of hug this right edge at the very beginning. And then as you're making this right turn, start hugging the left edge. It'll save a little bit of time. This part's pretty straightforward. Just kind of go slightly to the left of this mud here and keep going straight as much as you can. And you will save a little bit of time through there as well. Now with this little enemy pin, it's better if you go on the left side of him because you're about to make a left turn. If you go to the right, then you're going to have to make a wide right turn and that will start cutting down into your time as well. If you can completely miss this pin, that's even better. The pin doesn't take up a whole lot of your time, but I did notice that it causes a slight bit of lag, which will hurt your time just ever so slightly. So if you can, try to go to the left around him, but don't hit the wall on the left. It's better to hit the pin than to hit the wall on the left. And you also need to be careful because as you can see on this left side, there's a little bit of mud as well. So you can get caught in that trap too. So after you go to the left side of this pin, you're going to want to go where those cones are. Honestly, if you just run over those cones, you're in a really great spot to help you shave some time down. Because they're on the inside of turns and you can basically cut across some. This is another narrow path, and it's really, really tricky. As you can see, there's no guardrail, so there's a high chance you can fall off. I actually almost fell off right here. But the closer you can cut to that edge, the more time you will save as well. And another thing to note, like I said, this part can be pretty scary, but do not let that stop you from rolling the ball. Because if you adjust to try to slow down and make certain turns, you're going to lose time. And you'll see that I'm constantly getting the ball going, even through this part, even though it's a lot more difficult. it's better to constantly go and make sure you're not losing time. And if you fall off, to just start over instead of wasting so much time trying to make these. Because if you want a really good time, you're going to have to constantly be hitting the touchpad and keep the ball in motion. And right here, you're going to see I switch back to my thumbs to get some speed going. And this part can be a little tricky. Once you get it down, the ice part is actually not that bad. So let me show you kind of how I approach it. Okay. So right here in midair, I actually started a little earlier than I like to. But whenever you're in air, if you constantly roll the ball to the right, it's going to make a sharp turn and you're going to make it just fine whenever you drop down to the next level. The best and most optimal thing to do would be to cut across and basically make this jump on the corner. I didn't do it so well in this run, but it is not an easy task to pull off either. And that's something I tried to do, but I just didn't pull off as well. So let me show you kind of what this looks like. And then you're going to cut back to the left. Now you don't have to do it as early as I did it. You can actually wait until you get to the end of that small bridge and start cutting left. As long as you're fast enough, that is. As long as you cut to the left hard enough, you can actually still make it fairly easy. But I kind of like to try to cut that corner on the left if I can. So after that, about when I cross that little gap where that final ice block is whenever I'm going to start going forward. It's kind of like the whole cutting left. You can kind of change your direction almost immediately whenever you start going forward. And you see, I barely missed that enemy. So this part can be tricky if you're trying to save time. What I like to do here is cut this corner on the right side. You'll see that I kind of would have almost fell off. But if you got enough speed, you can actually basically just go right over the corner. Actually, I didn't realize that I was a little more close that time. But yeah, you can actually go right over that corner. The ball will drop just a little bit. If you get it just right, you won't lose any momentum. And this final part is pretty straightforward. You're just basically making a final run to the finish. And that's the whole tutorial that I have for this course. Like I said, sorry I can't really give a whole lot of tip and advice for this one as much as I can the other ones. This one, like I said, is kind of more like the climbing run. You're just going to have to keep practicing to get your top speed up. And that's really the first thing you should work on, is keeping your momentum going no matter what, to where you're not losing speed whatsoever. And then after you do that, then you can kind of find different ways and methods so that way you can make the turns a lot easier. Okay, so here we are back at the beginning. So I will show you the full run so that way you can see what this looks like. And there it is, there's the entire run. I was really trying to get a sub 32 time before I uploaded this video, but I have wasted enough time trying to get that, that I decided, okay, I'll get the video out. Everyone can kind of see what I'm doing anyway. And these are the same strategies that I found that really worked the best. If you get the sub 32, it's just mainly going to come down to me cutting those corners a little tighter. And as you can see by the world record, that it is very possible to get a sub 32. And you actually got more room than you realize. Alright, so now that this is, like I said, this is the final video of the tutorial. So I'm going to go back here and I'll just show you what my total time is as of standing right now. And when I looked at it, I do have the number one spot in the world for the best total time. It's not by much, though. I'm barely beating this one person. The next person behind them is nearly a second, and they are only 24 out of 100 seconds. But anyways, that's going to do the video. I hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you next time. So with that, take care. Good luck.